said I'm an animal. I'm just looking for the antidote. There's a British girl on my TV screen. She's so hot, she's so mean. Burn my body like it's flammable. Girl, I'm still a fan of you.
It's week 11 of the National Football League.
And coming up, we'll see the electric Jaden Daniels.
He's going to have to air it out plenty this week. It's the Commanders and the Niners under the lights on Sunday night.
Thank you to Trey Mosley for the introduction. We are indeed excited to welcome you to another edition of the NFL on EA Sports. Good to be in the booth with my partner Greg Olson. I'm Mike Tirico. Welcome, and Greg, this is one of those that's worthy of primetime because wide receivers love the spotlight as much as any position group in the league, and we got two guys who shine under the lights here tonight.
And I think where it's going to be really fun and get interesting to watch, Mike, is in those critical situations, the game's on the line, third down, red zone, gotta have it moments. There is no mystery. Both these sidelines, they know exactly where the ball's going, and they're just going to say, I dare you to stop them. These are two prime, elite wide receivers in the National Football League. Night game, prime time, they're looking to put on a show.
Opening carry of the game for the versatile Christian McCaffrey. And he will not be able to get free, picking up only a yard. Now, it's third down. Throwing from the gun is Purdy. And this ball incomplete on third down.
Remember what they told us, Mike, leading up to this game. They said it is so critical for us to find success, especially on third down. We want to maintain possession, extend these drives. Well, the first crack comes up, and they fail through the air, and we're going to have to regroup and be able to have better success throughout the remainder of this game.
And he's going to be brought down after a short return, and that's where his team will get possession of the football. The Washington offense going to make their way to the field for the first time. They are led by the former Heisman Trophy winner out of LSU, Jaden Daniels.
I think we're seeing this so often now in the modern NFL is quarterbacks who can hurt you both improv as a scrambler and also with designed runs coming out of the huddle. So this is a tricky situation. Guys who can run with this kind of speed, you have to be very careful how you pass rush them. You're not just rushing to a spot. It's not just an X behind the center. You got to try to corral him and keep him in the pocket because when he escapes, big plays are to be had.
Here's a third down and four. That's complete on the tight end screen. Nice job there defensively to keep him in front of the marker. It's going to bring up fourth down.
When you're willing to throw the ball short of the sticks on third down, you know what that tells me, Mike? The decision to go for it on fourth down has already been made. If you're able to pick it up with yards after the catch, great. But if not, it's a fourth and short, and you give yourself a realistic shot of converting on this fourth down.
So here's Brock Purdy and this 49ers offense heading back onto the field. He's building a case for the MVP. He is the leader in the NFL in touchdown passes as we move into the back half of the season. On first and 10, Purdy. Throw, left side, complete to Pearsall.
The receiver thought he had a nice soft spot in that zone coverage, and he settles down to give a nice target to the quarterback. But the defense had eyes on him the entire time. Secure rally tackle prevents that from turning into a big play.
And that's going to be incomplete. Coverage was good that time. The contact jarring the ball loose and forcing third down. Out of the gun, here's Purdy. He's got his man. Right side. It's complete.
He's in a really nice rhythm here on third down. He appears very comfortable operating out of the gun, and he's able to find his man near the sideline, and he's able to extend this drive.
They'll throw again with Purdy. And he got rid of that one quickly before the receiver even knew what was going on. That's incomplete. They'll try again here, second and 10. Up the middle, here's McCaffrey. And he'll get maybe a yard. That's it. It was Jeremy Chinn that time up to make the stop. Third down and 9. Shotgun snap to Purdy. Oh, he's going to be bottled up and taken down. They got him.
Sometimes you just have to know when the play is over and live to play another down. He has pressure coming right at him. And instead of just throwing the ball away, he tries to escape, he tries to get creative, and he ends up losing a lot more yards than he should have.
Here's Mitch Wisnowski now. He's on for the second time. He'll try to get something inside the 10. And no return forthcoming. It's a touchback and will come out to the 20-yard line. The home team's offense ready to take over for their second possession. They'll search for the first points of this game as they begin the drive on first and 10. From the shotgun, it's Daniels. Now he'll run it.
Initially, Mike, a really good job by the defense. Nowhere to go with the ball for this quarterback. He's forced to pull it down and turn into a runner. Little slow reaction, and he's able to actually pick up a pretty good game.
Daniels to throw on second down. A throw left side, going to be intercepted. Picked off by Jalen Watson.
You know, Mike, anytime a team can go nickel or dime and come off the field with an interception, I just am constantly reminded the importance of defensive back depth when you're building an NFL roster. I mean, think back. This is not the old NFL base 3-4, base 4-3. Offenses are going to roll out 2, 3, 4 high-level wide receivers at you in this pass-first modern era. If you can't roll out 5 DBs and all of them hold their own and be trusted to hold up, you are going to struggle defending these pass-first modern offenses.
Putting one of their tight ends in motion left. He's got a man. That's Kittle. And he's brought down after a gain of 6 on first down. They'll come up now for second down and 4. From the shotgun, it's Purdy. He keeps it himself. And the quarterback scrambling, maneuvers his way back to the line of scrimmage. But that's all he can get out of that one. Third down, 3 to go. Out of the gun, it's Purdy. And that is incomplete. Ricky Pearsall, the intended receiver. And it's going to be fourth down. So Jake Moody now out for the field goal. This is going to be from 53 yards out. Moody's kick is good. And the 49ers are out to an early 3-0 lead.
So it's not exactly what you're looking for when you set out on a drive, but at the same time, you don't want to come away empty-handed either. So in this case, they'll take those 3 points.
This is going to be taken in at the 3. He'll work his way across the 25-yard line. The Commanders offense getting their final instruction before heading back onto the field. This one has been tight so far. A field goal separating the two sides. As this drive kicks off with first and 10. This drive begins with a run by Harris. And he is stopped in his tracks. Loss of a couple on the play.
The speed and the get-off by the big interior defensive tackle, Mike. I mean, he got through there so fast, he almost took the handoff himself.
Throwing on second down, Daniel. Gets it away quickly, and it's caught. He'll get about six before he's taken down. Here comes third and six. Working out of the gun, it's Daniel. Quick throw, out wide, it's caught. And he's very close to a first down, but it doesn't look like he got there. And yes, they're going to mark him a yard short. On comes the punter now. And he is hoping to improve on his first attempt. 49ers offense getting things in order as they trot out for this next possession. They'll look to build on their 3-0 lead as this drive starts with a first and 10. Play fake to McCaffrey. Now Purdy. And the coverage right there. This ball knocked away. It's incomplete. A second down throw here for Purdy. He'll find his open man. That's Brandon Ayuk. And they bring him down, but not until he crosses midfield. Purdy on target to Ayuk. And the 49ers have a first down. So we are through one on Sunday Night Football. The Niners have the early advantage. And EA Sports NFL Sunday returns after this. Set to go now on first and 10. They'll try the left side with McCaffrey. Angling to the sideline, inside the 35. Oh, what a run. Down inside the 30-yard line.
I've always gone by the philosophy, Mike, that the pass sets up the run. And in these last two plays, that's exactly what happened. You hit them with the big pass, they adjust. You soften them up a little bit, you take advantage for the big gain on the ground.
Purdy now, he'll throw on first down. He's got his tight end, Braden Willis. And he will get into the end zone. Braden Willis, touchdown, 49ers. That touchdown number one for him on the year.
Just a beautiful ball there by the quarterback. And the point I want to make here, Mike, and make sure the viewer understands, is in the NFL, if you have to wait for a guy to be open and then deliver the ball, it's too late. So often these quarterbacks throw their guy open. They anticipate where the void in the coverage is going to be. That's exactly the reason this play worked out here, Mike, and he's able to connect here for a big touchdown.
So, following that touchdown, Moody is back out to kick it off. Now, return coming from the 7. And he'll work this one past the 25 to right about the 28-yard line. The Commanders' offense make their way out to take over once more. And nothing doing from the offense just yet. Down 10-0 as they come up with 1st and 10. Off-balance throw, it's complete. And they'll get about half of what they needed. It's a pickup of 5 and sets up 2nd and 5. At the 33-yard line. Daniels now going to look to throw. Now a screen set up for Harris. They'll mark him down up at the 44-yard line. On the give, it's Harris. Nice gain on first down, but the penalty flags come in. And the question now, will the play stand? Operating from the gun, it's Daniels. That's caught downfield. McLaurin brings it in. And he will score. Terry McLaurin. Touchdown, Washington. Chad Ryland now for the extra point. He's got it. And the Commanders are on the board. It's 10-7. Here's Ryland now. After the TD, he'll send this one away. The return starts from the 5. He'll get across the 20, mark him down 23-yard line. Here's Christian McCaffrey and the 49ers offense coming back onto the field. As we take a look at the league leaders in receiving touchdowns, he tops all other NFL running backs to this point in the season. Throwing on first down is Purdy. A dive and a catch. Incredible. That one good for a dozen and a very quick first down. Purdy works out of the pistol. He'll look underneath here for McCaffrey. And they'll get about half of what they needed. It's a pickup of 5 and sets up 2nd and 5. Throwing from the gun is Purdy. That's over the middle to Kittle. The tackle's going to be made down at the 40-yard line.
This is a great example, Mike, of just how effective it is when you're efficient on early downs throwing the ball. I mean, when you can pick up first downs without getting to third down, as the game unfolds, things just get easier and easier. Take what the defense is giving you. Don't force the ball downfield. But when you can stay ahead of the chains without having to get to third and have it plays, that's when an offense is really firing. It's a really good job defensively. The key is you don't want your defensive linemen to overcommit to rushing the passer, and you don't want your linebackers and secondary dropping too deep defending the pass. In this case, all three levels played discipline, good football with good vision. That's why they're able to stop him for no gain.
And they'll hold him to a gain of just a couple and sets up third down. To the air again is Purdy. Open man, left side, he's got it. A gain of 11 on that one. It's good for a Niners first down.
There's this misconception out there, Mike, that in the NFL you have to run the same amount of run plays as you do pass plays. And as you're seeing in this drive, you can fall on one side of that coin a little bit more as long as you're able to remain effective and efficient. So far, their passing game has dominated here early, and that last pickup leads to a first down.
On second down, it's McCaffrey. And he will have the first down. Not a huge run, but enough to move the chains. So Kittle comes in motion. This one is complete along the sideline. A very nice job to fit that ball in. It'll be a modest gain. Here's 2nd and 9. Back to throw, Purdy. That's into traffic, but taken in. And he's going to be taken down as we hit the 2-minute warning here in this first half. We need 2. Here's Purdy. And this is going to be incomplete. That is great work there, making things difficult defensively. It'll set up a 4th down. Now Purdy. This one caught at the four. And they will get the conversion. He's tackled down near the goal line, so it's not a touchdown, but it will be first and goal. Ah, good blocking, and he's in. Isaac Guerrero. Touchdown, San Francisco. Good drive. They kept the ball. Greg, they moved it effectively down the field and finish it off on the ground for the touchdown.
So often, Mike, we see teams work on a great drive to get down here close only to settle for a field goal. But in this case, give them a lot of credit. They put a great drive together, but they're able to capitalize and finish it off with six.
Moody's extra point is good. And the 49ers will get out in front 17-7. So, following that touchdown, Moody is back out to kick it off. This taken in at the 8-yard line. And they'll bring him down just shy of the 30-yard line. There's Terry McLaurin and the Commanders offense heading out for their next possession. They find themselves down 17-7 as this drive starts. First and 10. From the shotgun, it's Daniels. Off he goes. The Commanders will signal for the first of their timeouts, and they'll get together prior to the second down play. Here's Daniels. And that's a first down. It will be a gain of 8. Now a timeout here by Washington. That is their second.
These are the play calls, Mike, that offensive coordinators use to just get their quarterback and their passing game into some sort of rhythm. Easy pitch and catch, get the ball out of his hand, see a completion. These typically, as the game goes on, lead to bigger and bigger gains.
Taking off.
He tried to buy all the time he could, but when he saw that space, he quickly turned from thrower to runner, and he's able to pick up a nice gain on first down.
Here's second and 2. They'll throw with Daniels. That one knocked away and incomplete. Diamador Lenore there defensively to break that one up. Now a 3rd and 2. 3rd and 2. Here's Daniels. He manages to get the throw away and completes it. Good work after the catch. They gain 19 yards and a first down.
You don't want to make a living off of making these kind of throws, Mike. It's one thing to throw into tight coverage, but it's another thing to throw into tight double coverage. And while the quarterback gets away with one here, I don't think you want to make a living doing it.
So they come to the line for first down and 10. Working out of the gun, it's Daniels. He'll be forced to just throw that one away. It's incomplete.
Up until that incompletion, they've done a really nice job on this drive, Mike, picking up fresh sets of downs. And typically, throwing the ball on first down is a great way to do it. But now they find themselves in 2nd and 10. Do you keep it in the air and try to get the first down here? Or is the idea to just make third down manageable and take your chances picking up a key third down?
On third down, they'll throw with Daniels. He'll try to run for it. He's going to be brought down very close to that line to gain. They're going to mark him just a bit short. And now it's 4th down. They'll go. Here's Daniels. And he's going to have a Commanders, and he's going to have the Jets. Now Daniels. This is caught at the 2. And the Commanders are going to have a 1st and goal. Very nearly a touchdown. He's going to be marked out of bounds just shy of the pylon.
It's been a really good drive so far. But what I really like, Mike, is they're down here in the red zone, and they continue to attack. Now, not quite a touchdown, but with 1st and goal, this defense certainly has their back against the ropes.
Ryland's kick is good, and the Commanders are back within a score, It's now 17-10.
All right, Mike, thanks very much. As mentioned, this is the EA Sports Halftime Report. Time to take a look around the NFL and find out what's going on this fine Sunday. We'll start up at Highmark Stadium, just outside of Buffalo, where it was definitely a game with some intrigue, as you can see by the scoreline. Patrick Mahomes, strong in the win, as his guys run their record to 8-2 with the W. From there, we take the trip across Lake Erie to check on the Lions at home in Detroit. And they were losers in that one to the visiting Minnesota Vikings. J.J. McCarthy, excellent in the victory, as it's one that pushes his guys two games above 500. And lastly, Monday Night Football has a good one lined up between the New Orleans Saints and the Seattle Seahawks. These two teams making their way back out of their locker room, so that means we're just about set for the second half. And to bring it your way, we go back out to Mike and Greg.
Coach, thanks. This one's still anyone's game. We'll see who can come out with the hot hand in this second half. About to get started. This is fielded inside the five. And a decent return there. He'll get this up just shy of the 30. The Commanders' offense and their running back getting set for this next possession. And he's had trouble getting on track in this one. Really limited space to find an opening. The defensive front stopping him multiple times. Generally, he has not been a big factor in this game to this point. They'll go play action here with Daniels. On target, got it to McCoy. And he's going to take this one all the way. 71 yards. Touchdown, Washington. Extra point now by Ryland. He gets it to go. And the Commanders will come back to tie things at 17. So back to level after the touchdown and time for the kickoff. A return now from the four. He'll get this past the 20 before he's brought down shy of the 25-yard line. The Niners' offense and Christian McCaffrey getting set for their next possession. And they love to find different ways to get him the football. Look there. He comes into this week second in the NFL in receiving yards out of the backfield. A first down throw for Purdy. That's caught by McCaffrey. That's a nice pickup on a first down throw. It's a gain of 8. He'll come to the line now on 2nd and 2. They'll send a tight end in motion. Purdy now on 2nd down. And he'll be taken down. The gain is 6, and it's a new set of downs. He picked up the first down. Shotgun snap to Purdy. No one open. He'll drop it to his running back. That's a nice pickup on a first down throw. It's a gain of 8. Again in the air for Purdy. That's complete to Kittle, the tight end. And that's a first down. It will be a gain of 8. One of the tight ends in motion right. They run straight ahead with McCaffrey. And he powers his way forward, doing it on the ground inside the 40, a gain of 8. They run once more with McCaffrey. And it doesn't appear that he got to that first down marker. They'll only give him a yard, so it'll set up third down. They'll try to run for it with McCaffrey. And he didn't need much, but I don't think he got there. It's going to depend on the spot. Looks like he is short on that one.
Coming off that edge, Mike, you have to quickly determine, is this a pass or is it a run? And once he realized it was a run, he's able to shed his blocker, make the play, no gain.
And that is no good. He missed it. And this will remain a tie ball game.
And this is the danger of trying these long field goals. Remember, Mike, if you miss, the other team gets the ball at the spot of the kick. So it's going to end up setting them up for great field position as they start this next drive.
They'll come up here first and 10. Off the play fake, here's Daniels. Thrown into a sea of bodies, but it's complete. And they'll move this one down inside the 40-yard line.
This is a great opportunity now for the offense to really seize control of this game. They just saw their opponent miss a field goal try, come out aggressive on the ensuing possession, strike deep early. Now see if they can put this drive together and end it with some points.
Belgio. On that hookup, good for a Commanders first down. A run. Here's Harris. Finding space at the 15. And he's going to take this all the way home. Touchdown, Commanders.
That just feels like a big drive, doesn't it, Mike? Here in the second half, you got a tie ball game. Now you're able to get out in front. Let's see how this other team responds, having to play from behind.
We got a ton of time, Greg, but a little momentum feel. Come out of the locker room, take the lead. Now it's up to the other team to climb uphill. So great way, perfect way to get this second half started. Here's Ryland now. After the TD, he'll send this one away. This will be returned from the 6. He'll get this up to the 28-yard line. Nice place for the drive to start. The Niners offense makes their way back out to the field for their next possession. They trail here by a touchdown as this drive will start with a first down. On the zone read, a give to Guerrero. And tough running there. He's up to the 32. It was Jeremy Chinn that time up to make the stop. Here's 2nd and 6. From the gun, it's Purdy. A short one there, caught by Kittle. And he'll be taken down. The gain is 6, and it's a new set of downs. He picked up the first down. Purdy works out of the pistol. Right back to Kittle. That's another one. And he's down inside the 40-yard line.
And if he's late with that throw, Mike, there's a really good chance a defender could have made a play on it. But he does a beautiful job. He puts the ball out in front of his shoulder, leads the receiver, and allows him to get upfield and pick up the first down.
First and 10 now from the 36. From the shotgun, it's Purdy. And the rush gets home. He'll go down. They got him.
This is a great example of the game within the game. They're making what they call Mike declaration, and that's what sets the responsibilities of all the protectors. And in this case, the Mike was the one who came. He's unblocked, and he's able to get home.
Throwing on 2nd down is Purdy. And that'll go for a gain of 7, and it's going to set up 3rd down. Here's Purdy. Quick throw here is complete. Well, this one is in reverse again. They're going to lose more yardage here, and it's going to bring up fourth down. So Jake Moody now out for the field goal. This officially a 58-yard attempt. Moody's kick is good. And the Niners will cut the lead down to four.
So anytime an offense comes off the field after settling for three, you always have to take the good with the bad. In order to get down there in field goal range, you had to do something positive to move the ball. But at the same time, how are we going to be able to finish these drives and convert for six the next time we get down there?
The home team's offense and Jaden Daniels ready to take over once more. And he's had it going in the first half. Really had his way with the secondary. They have been powerless to stop him. Now, they're trying to keep it going. And that one's going to be shut down quickly. A minimal gain. Hook him up on a second down and eight.
Brings up second and eight at the 30-yard line.
So, three quarters have come and gone. And Sunday Night Football continues after this. Second down and eight. Play action. Here's Daniels. The pass rush gets home, and he goes down.
Big-time opportune sack there by the defense. Mike, they're right on the cusp of field goal range. You can't allow this to become a two-possession ball game here in the fourth quarter. Massive third down coming up here. See if they can get off the field and get the ball back to their offense.
So, backed up after the sack, and now it's third and long. Daniels now going to look to throw. Now a screen set up for Harris. He's going to be brought down very close to that line to gain. They're going to mark him just a bit short. And now it's fourth down. The Commanders about to send this one away as they try to play the field position game here, protecting a fourth quarter lead. And we will not see a return on this one, as it will be marked down. Here's the San Francisco offense, ready to take possession of the ball once more. They trail by four, touchdown gives them the lead. Drive begins with first and ten. He'll start this drive by keeping it himself. Not a whole lot happening there, just a short pickup. On second down, Purdy. He'll find his tight end, Kittle, on the right side. And he's going to be brought down up past the 45.
And this is a tricky part of the game for any defense. You find yourself protecting a late lead, and the age-old question is, do you remain aggressive? Do you try to just keep the ball from being thrown over your head and make everything be tackled and played in front of you? That's what every defensive coordinator struggles with, so they can't get too soft here as they try to hold on to this lead here late.
On first and 10, it's Purdy. Oh, in trouble. Down he goes. Now, following that sack, we have a player who was injured. So as they look at the injured player, we'll take a timeout. Out of the gun, here's Purdy. Quick throw, out wide, it's caught.
Outbreaking routes, Mike, especially outside of the numbers. Everything is about the timing. If you're late with the throw, you're going to be watching that defensive back take that thing the other way for six.
Pressure gets there, and down he goes.
We're starting to see in these passing situations, Mike, this defensive line is starting to have their way against this group up front, because right now their pass protection is breaking down and this quarterback's paying the price for it.
The 49ers out to punt this one. They'll be forced to punt, trailing here in the fourth quarter. That is fielded at the 20. And it'll be brought down, short return, and they'll take over there. The home team's offense and their quarterback set to take the field once more. And he has been masterful so far leading this offense, keeping the mistakes to a minimum, on point with his passes, generally one step ahead of the defense all game long.
At this stage in the fourth quarter, great job by the defense, understanding exactly what the offense is trying to do. They're trying to bleed the clock, shorten the game. They completely sold out to stop the run, able to take them down for a loss.
And he's going to be dropped after a pickup of about 5.
Just take what the defense is giving you. When you can stay ahead of the chains and just take these easy pitch and catch throws underneath, hitch routes, quick game, now it puts you in a lot more favorable down and distances to eventually attack this defense a little bit more downfield. This is the point in the game, Mike, where on third down, you have to get off the field, and they do a great job. They defend everything in the pass routes, nowhere for the quarterback to go with the ball, but they don't keep him in the pocket. They let him escape, picks up the first down with his legs. They're going to be able to run more time off the clock.
And he maneuvers his way forward, a gain of 6.
He's brought down at the 42-yard line.
They'll work now on 2nd and 4. Working out of the gun, it's Daniel. Gets it away quickly, and it's caught. And they'll whistle him down, but not before it picks up a first down after a gain of 7. Give up the middle to Harris. And he'll plow forward for a gain of 4 yards. Here's a 2nd and 6.
It's now 2nd and 6 at the Niners' 47-yard line.
At the RPO, this one to McLaurin.
Offensively, landing a lot of body blows on this drive, Mike. Just the ability to steadily march the ball downfield and remain so efficient, both run and pass. As they continue to wear this defense out, they have to find a way to end this drive with points. Anything short of that would be a bit of a letdown.
On the handoff, it's Harris. Not much to speak of on that one. Maybe a gain of a yard. It's 2nd down. Another run here with Harris. And he'll get this ahead. Gain of about 4. And it leads to 3rd down.
Here we go, set. Hey.
They'll drop to throw. Open man, right side. He's got it. The Niners will use their 3rd and final timeout. They'll be disappointed there after giving up the 1st down. The defense still with all 3 timeouts at their disposal as the quarterback's down 2 and E. Lost 1 on the last play, so now it's 2nd and 11. A give, and here comes Harris. And he's bottled up after a gain of 1 yard. A couple of 3rd down conversions already on this drive. This one tougher. This is 3rd and 10. Victory formation here as he's down 2 and E.
Chad Ryland on for the field goal. A 44-yard attempt.
Personal foul, roughing the kicker, defense. That penalty is declined.
So it's a win here for the Commanders. Their winning ways continue. They've yet to be stopped as they remain unbeaten in the month of November. And that'll do it for my partner Greg Olson. For our entire team, I'm Mike Tirico. This has been a presentation of the NFL on EA Sports. The Commanders are winners, as we say so long from just outside our nation's capital.